Okay, it is April 19, 2016. This video will entail my posting two videos because I'm going to read the entire essay that has been posted on geoengineeringwatch.org, which everybody should bookmark and circulate it to all of those who are in your life who are remaining willfully ignorant, choosing to be ignorant on a very, very important and dangerous issue, an operation that we are all facing. An operation that is taking place that is destroying people's lives and the lives of many species. Like horses, 70 stranded in Houston. And here are people trying to rescue this horse. This is not okay that people are choosing to remain willfully ignorant. But this is an Air Force officer who has written an essay that Dame Wigington has posted on his website. An Air Force officer warning of atmospheric spraying and the coming collapse. I'm not going to read the preface that Dane has written here, but for the first two sentences, and then I will go right into the essay. And I hope that you circulate this. Please print it out, hand it to those in your life that are remaining willfully ignorant. Because unfortunately, the willfully ignorant are keeping us in a reality that is extremely dangerous. This is not a light or laughing matter. It is a danger to all of our lives. The great unraveling is gaining momentum by the day. And even now, the majority of the masses are fast asleep at the wheel. Our skies look like something from an apocalyptic future. Our trees are dying. Our oceans are dying. Our planet is dying. And still the majority remain unaware. Former Air Force officer gives a stern warning. This article is written by Colonel Randall Smith, PhD, Commander, NECN, and contributing writer for geoengineeringwatch.org. This is what he has to say. To a very great extent, America is fighting several wars, some on foreign soil, one on our own soil. Aside from disrupting or eliminating the flow of items key to survival, clean water, nourishment, sanitary living conditions, etc., governments, federal and state, are executing plans for complete disruption of our usual means of communication. This includes landlines, cellular, VoIP, and the internet. You are already acutely aware of the blackout of the major news organizations, how they are not reporting the truth. All of those news organizations owned and controlled by major corporations or banksters. I am a former United States Air Force electronics communications officer and a licensed amateur radio operator. Several years ago, as I began to learn more of what at the time seemed to be literally unbelievable, I thought about the need for an emergency communications network that would reach beyond our shores and borders and to which every American could have access for a nominal cost in equipment and without a license from the now Department of Homeland Security's dominated Federal Communications Commission. Several colleagues across the United States are attempting to do the same thing at the state level. For example, in my own state, it is fellow oath keepers who have stepped forward to assist in this undertaking. In other states, it is their militias who have accepted this important responsibility, though I wish I could report that all states have in place an emergency communications network. For various reasons, I cannot. Some of those reasons include lethargy, fear, the infamous somebody else will do it syndrome, and religious precepts, among others. My first active duty assignment was at Vandenberg Air Force Base, California, with the 1st Strategic Aerospace Division. As a young shavetail from the Midwest, I soon came to love California and many of the people I met while stationed there. It has been painful for me to follow the drought situation that affects so many people in so many different ways. It has been equally painful to come to understand the reasons behind that drought. By now, you are certainly aware of the nationwide airborne aerosol spraying program, which is and has been for years conducted by the United States Air Force, United States Navy, and the United States Coast Guard. KC-135 and perhaps other aircraft, which were originally designed and built as tankers to permit in-flight refueling, have been converted to carry payloads of a wide variety of chemical and biological payloads. Fitted with nozzles, they have dispersed and are dispersing tons of these agents over all of the lower 48 states, plus Alaska and Hawaii. This project is not limited to the United States or North America. It is part of a world plan. At first, many Americans thought that these were the familiar contrails that followed jet engines at altitude, as a B-52 and, ironically, a KC-135 electronics officer, I can tell you with absolute certainty that these are not contrails. Contrails are created when very hot burned jet fuel vapors combine with cooler, humid air. The interaction of the two causes a cloud-like contrail. Typically, contrails are fairly short in length, and they dissipate after only a few seconds, so long as ambient air is cool and humid. They do not grow in width as a function of time. Very few Americans have not noticed what have come to be known as chemtrails, chemical trails, which may run in parallel lines or perpendicular patterns in our skies. To my knowledge, no portion of the United States has been spared. There is a great deal of useful and helpful information on chemtrails, geoengineering, on the internet. As always, be selective in what you read and think critically. Many reasons have been given in regard to the purposes of these flights. Reasons have included such things as reduction in global warming, redirection of violent weather patterns to safer locations, and aid in military communications, a defense against enemy radar and satellite surveillance, reconnaissance, etc. Another frequently cited reason has to do with controlling the weather of other countries. Sorry, Snagit just gave me my 1 minute warning, particularly those in which we have troops involved in conflicts. There were also many reasons given in the FEMA Walmart conspiracy. For example, these stores are being closed because of multiple simultaneous plumbing problems. I'm going to end this now and pick it up in another video, which I will post immediately when it's done.